All right, welcome back to Musik Fest, day two. We are gearing up for another round of food, drinks, and of course Musik Fest festivities. And this time, we brought the cavalry with us. We have got Pa in the back and John Blaylock up front. John, what's going on, man? How are you doing with everything going on and everything like that? You excited for the Musik
Fest? Very excited. It's been 2 years since I've been to Musik Fest.
So, really? 2 years?
2 years.
Holy
two
crap.
2 years. So I'm back. I'm ready for all the festivities.
Ready for round two.
Round two.
That's awesome, man. We are currently working our way out of the parking garage and down to our first stop of the day, just like yesterday, Bethlehem Brew Works. So yesterday we didn't get too much of an opportunity to do much drinking or anything like that. Obviously me and Jen drove ourselves, so we had to make sure we could drive back. And on top of that, it was raining a lot more yesterday, pretty much throughout our entire day. It looks like it's a little bit sunnier outside, even though it is overcast and everything. So we are gonna do our best to sip a little bit more today. We're gonna grab some Musik Fest mugs so that we've got the traditional giant refill that we can take advantage of throughout the day. And maybe we'll bounce around to a couple more areas. I think the marketplace is actually open today. It was closed yesterday, so maybe we can explore that. So this is what I was talking about right here. You see these signs all around Musik Fest. And these signs basically tell you how much of a discount you can get when you bring your Musik Fest mug to that location, and of course what drinks you can get with it.
So we need four.
Yeah.
Winky Blinkies.
The Blinky ones.
The Winky Blinkies.
The Winky Blinkies.
We have to test them, please.
Oh, you know
how to
test
them. Yes.
I'm sure the Winkies are blinking. Winky and a Blinky.
No.
Yes.
Okay. Have our official Winky Blinky Musik Fest mug that you can refill at various locations throughout the entire fair, festival, event, whatever you want to call it. And then we also got this like little program, I think it is. So this will be useful for checking out where new tents are, certain events are going on, all that fun stuff. Thank you. Wow. Quality service. Thank you. All right, so what is everybody looking to start out with?
I'm actually going to start off with that Steelworkers chili.
Okay, a chili is nice. That's a good choice for today.
Definitely that.
Matches the weather.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
John, what about you?
I am definitely going to have to start with the beer cheese soup.
Okay, that yes, is, a staple.
A staple.
Gotta have it. Love that. Babe, what are you thinking?
Beer cheese soup and a Moscow Mule. Please okay. And thank you.
I think I am going to go beer cheese soup. Maybe pretzels with it, maybe. Ooh. But I don't want to fill up on anything too hearty because you got to leave room to be able to hop around and everything. So that'll be a game time decision. I was about to say, are we kicking it off with drinks or are we chilling right now?
I'm going to do a sampler, I think.
Okay, all right.
Pop Explosion, the Squishy Kitty, the Bohemian Lifestyle, the Czech Sunset, ESB, and the Oatmeal Stout.
I'll do the London Mule.
Czech Sunset as well. The Freshy Golden Lager. We'll try Blueberry Belch, that sounds fun. Yeah. Throw Space Monkey on there, we'll do that. And let's do ESB as well. I'll try the Squishy Kitty, why not?
Yeah.
All right. Some interesting names for some of these beers on here. Not sure what goes into the entire naming process, but we'll see how reflected the names are of the flavors once we get them. All right, Pa, light it up, give me the demonstration. Oh, very nice. Those lights are actually stronger than what I would have thought they'd be.
A static. And then off.
Nice. Very good. For when you want to go incognito, right?
Yeah, this is the stealth.
That's the stealth mode.
This is I'm here and you can't miss me.
Yep.
This is I'm here and maybe you could miss me.
Yeah.
Stealth mode.
Love it.
This is a story from my first Musik Fest, which was over 10 years ago now.
Okay.
And we got the Winky Blinky mugs. I was living in New York at the time.
Uh-huh.
And I put my Winky Blinky in, you remember this, right? In my kitchen cabinet above the refrigerator. And about 2 months later, and that, I didn't touch it or anything, about 2 months later, in the middle of the night, I was going into the kitchen and the entire kitchen was this color.
Oh no.
Coming from the cabinet. I swear that UFOs had landed in my kitchen. I was like, what is happening? Winky Blinky Mug just turned on in the middle of the night.
Yes, it was calling you. That was the bat signal.
Right, exactly.
Was like, come back to us.
That's funny.
Of
Is it still?
Well, now you got a new one. It's recharged, right. And you can continue
now
the tradition.
I'm going to put this in my kitchen cabinet and see what happens. 2 months from now, I'll let you know.
Hello. Okay. Mule is there. It's coming in hot. Look at that. Beer sampler to kick off the day.
Thank you.
And we got John's over there as well.
The receipt, top to bottom, is my beer flavors from left to right. So we're gonna work our way around and see how we do. It looks like we're starting with the blueberry belch over here on the left. I'm getting fruity notes in there. I don't know if I've got blueberry coming through at all, but I'm definitely getting some type of fruit. Blueberry belch is good. It's got like a tart flavor kind of behind it. Sweet and tart. Now the blueberry kind of flavor comes through, or the blueberry fame to claim comes through. Let's go with the Czech Sunset next. That's our next one up here. Smells light. Airy. Okay. That one's good too. A little bit more bite to it. A little bit more hoppy in there. But again, good beer. ESB. Extra special brew or beer, so we'll go with that. Why not? If anything, it's a light aroma of hops coming through. To be expected. It's a beer. That one's good. To me, that one's the most like straightforward beer flavor. Not too hoppy. No major other aromas or flavor notes popping in there. Nothing sweet or anything like the blueberry belch. This one just tastes like a nice, clean, straight, light beer. Extra special bitter is supposed to be what ESB stands for. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not tasting anything bitter in here. The Czech Sunset was a little bit more hoppy, a little bit more of a bite and a bitter taste to me. Not in a bad way, of course. But yeah, this one's not bad. For me, this one is second. Blueberry Belch is still first. Czech Sunset is last, but again, not in a bad way. Looking at a freshie coming up next. This one is very light. Can you guys see that color right there? This one smells more hoppy, definitely. More of a bitter aroma smell to it. Let's see how it tastes. Oddly refreshing. Very refreshing. Not really as bitter taste-wise as it smells, but very smooth, very refreshing beer. This is something I would crack after like maybe like a long hot day outside, honestly. This one bumped up to number two for me. Blueberry Belch is still in first, but this is definitely number two. I like this one. Space Monkey, this one sounds interesting. I feel like I've had this one before. It looks familiar. It's got a unique color, almost pink in there. That's pretty cool. Nothing major aroma-wise coming through. Maybe a little bit of fruit somewhere in there hidden. Ooh, Space Monkey's very tart. Very juice flavor. I'd honestly like to check and see if that one was more of a, I forget what they're called. They're like the fruity mixed beers or something like that, so. Very good though. Space Monkey is not bad at all. I like that.
You like it?
Oh yeah, definitely.
Raspberry flavor.
Raspberry, that's what it is coming through. It's raspberry. Okay, because I was about to say the blueberry one definitely gave me blueberry. I couldn't put my tongue on which berry it was for that one. Let's give our final taste test real quick. This is the Squishy Kitty. This one smells very light and fruity. Almost like a sourish, fruity, hoppy flavor coming through. Got a little bit of hoppiness in there. A little bit, tiny little bite at the end, but mostly it's more of like a sour popping through for the beer flavor. These were all great choices. If I had to pick one to come out on top, it's definitely between the Space Monkey and the Blueberry Belch. Tiebreaker between the two, I think I'm gonna go Blueberry Belch. That one was, in my opinion, one of the best ones to kick off with and still one of the favorites for me, but Space Monkey is a close second for sure. Of course, we have to have the beer cheese soup. Again, this is a regular occurrence in Pennsylvania. This is a regular occurrence anytime we come to Musik Fest. Just can't be beat. It's delicious.
Second round of apps has come. This is the beer cheese soup, of course, but with the pretzels from Bethlehem Brew Work. Again, just absolute magic. And then John's got some nachos over here, looking good. And Paul diving into a nice, fresh looking salad. And a unique dressing over there. What dressing did we go with again, Paul?
A maple vinaigrette, balsamic vinaigrette, a little maple flavor, yeah.
All right, give us a taste test. Tell us your first thoughts.
Oh yeah. Let's see, let's get some of the dressing first.
Yep, get a little dab. What do we got?
Definitely maple flavor. mixed with a balsamic vinaigrette. Very good.
Okay. Would you do it again?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Very
love
good.
That. We love that. The beer sampler is officially crushed. She took away the rest of my beers, so we are just going to polish this one off. And those beers filled me up a little bit more than expected. I haven't drank beer like that in a while, but it's okay. We'll walk it off and make some more room. So cheers to kicking off day number two. Back outside, get some fresh air and a little bit of movement to help with digesting all of that beer and beer cheese soup. Let's see what else we can find on our second day of Musik Fest. Look at what we've got. We have an unexpected gift here. I'm gonna have to show this to you guys later, break it out in the basement and demonstrate it. We've got a full Herf cigar ashtray and lighter gifted to us by Paul. That was really sweet. This is gonna be a real treat to break out for you guys later and show you guys how this works. It's absolutely insane. Man, great Musik Fest.
I've got a couple extra pieces in my pocket. I'll do it in slow motion though. Watch this slow motion. Clap your hand, people. Give me some energy. Yes, yes, yes. All right, sir.
In here. Hey. Good to see you again, boss. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Doing well, man. We brought some of our family along with us. This is John and this is Pa over here. This is our dog. Yeah, we were telling him about your stand and your tots, man. It was good.
Okay.
Yeah, man.
For a vegan?
We're gonna bounce down around to the market and stuff like that. We might come back around when we have a little bit more room in our stomachs, man.
Sounds good.
Definitely, man.
I'll be here all night.
Sounds good. Maybe we'll see you later today. Yeah, this was closed yesterday, but they've decided to open it up. We can legally trespass back here. And like I said, since we can legally trespass, we will. Let's take a little detour, see what we can find. That's how you know that everybody else is a flat-out tourist. They're taking the main routes, all of the well-traveled ones, the public routes. Me and my caravan, we are taking the scenic route, the road less traveled, the beaten path. Well, unbeaten path, sorry. We have finally made it around to the marketplace area and bottom section of Musik Fest. I'm not gonna lie, they didn't make this very easy to access. The stairwell that we usually kind of cut through and pop out somewhere over there was locked off by like trees and construction and all that stuff, so had to re-navigate our way around, but we made it. We are officially down in a main market area.
How's life? Good. We got my future son-in-law right here.
Hey, how are you?
Oldest daughter, Cameron, Jennifer, John from California.
California?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Made the long haul for this one, man.
Did you get him a coat?
Oh, no, he doesn't get that. That's not included. That's a premium package.
Oh, yeah.
Ken, we've been around your candles for a minute here, man. We know that these are all homemade and custom and everything. You do a pretty good job of showing up here every year, yeah?
Sometimes.
He tries, right?
This week we haven't flooded, so I'm happy.
That's good. Do you have anything special this year? Anything that pops out, any new scents or anything?
Well, we have a couple crazy ones. But again, it's 30 years. It's hard to make new smells.
Yeah, after a while, right?
This year we made this spring was a Fruity Pebbles. It smells like cereal.
Okay, very cool. We're going to have to give that one a sniff. Anything else?
Well, the only other new one we made was one called Woodstock.
Woodstock,
which
okay.
I affectionately called Old Hippie.
Got it. And what does that one smell like?
A lot of herbal
smells.
Old hippie?
Now, I have smelled his candles before.
Found them in
and Ken is pretty talented at making things work.
No, it's tough.
Year after year, comes back
a little exercise
and gets candles from Ken. Now, Paul, what are some of your favorite candles,
scents-wise? All of the bakery.
Bakery ones?
Scents.
So the cookies.
Pardon me, that's right. If I'm not sure I should smell them or eat them,
right.
Then it's the right candy.
Very. We're going to go ahead and give this Fruity Pebble one a smell real fast. And it's good. Very good. It's got a very like strong base note of kind of like a vanilla going in there, which I think is kind of one of those hidden undertones that you don't really immediately pick up or immediately identify when you're having cereal, but it's definitely always there, at least in my opinion. Kind of like candied sugar fruit. I think the most important part for me is that it's not overwhelming. It's very easy to ruin a candle experience when the smell is super artificial, super strong, super just like overwhelming to the point where it gives you a headache. I'm not getting this here.
Vanilla waffle cone.
Very nice. Is that a regular in the lineup or
no?
New one?
It's going to be now.
Let me give this a try.
I'm behind yeah, that you, one, kiddo.
That
you,
one's good. It smells like sweet vanilla wafer dessert. That's awesome. And so we smelled your Fruity Pebbles. That one smelled amazing. I know you probably don't have as many new flavors. It gets pretty hard after, like, you know, 30 plus years of doing it and everything.
We've got 80 different kinds here.
Yeah. I was curious, what are some of your most popular ones?
Every year, the clean linen is a bestseller, which makes me laugh. It's a fabric softener sheet. That's always number one.
Okay.
The top five, it varies, but most of the time it would be the lemongrass and lavender, which is a really cool one.
Okay, gotcha.
Orange and evergreen.
Cool.
Island breeze.
Right.
And then it depends. Some, it has been sandalwood. That kind of goes up and down with the
right.
English tea sometimes, but that's gone down a little bit.
Okay. He said the blueberry lemonade was actually one of the popular and in-demand ones. So let's give that one a quick little scent.
This one's in my bathroom right now.
Nice. Now that one, that one smells very sweet, puckery, kind of tart almost. Getting the blueberry lemonade? Okay, there you go. Yeah, it's very, the lemonade scent is very, very clear in there. He actually did a really good job of bringing that out. For me, that would be like a bathroom candle. The scent is very strong. It's not something I would want wafting around my house the entire day, but definitely to pop in for a little bit and to cover some potentially unwanted smells, that'd be good. And those of you who are curious, Ken's got, of course, all these different options over here. Tons of large candles, all that stuff. He's also got the scenty blocks as well, for those of you who prefer using a scentsy as well. And then, of course, different sizes. You can get a small, you can get a medium size, or you can get a large, whatever suits you fancy. So, Ken, you've got the best candles at Music Fest. Can you let our viewers know where we can find you online? I know you've got a website, right?
LittleHouseCandles.com.
Okay, cool. And can they place any order they want? Do you ship all over the country, or is there limitations?
Contiguous 48 states. We'll ship it to you.
All right. Thanks, Ken. Appreciate you, man. Wow, that's awesome. I was going to say, it looks like it's currently under construction. Are we building the rest of a guitar up here?
Kind of.
Kind of?
Kind of.
Or are you just doing the graphics and stuff on the front?
Kind of, yeah.
Lots of kind ofs going on here. This is a precarious art project. Gotcha. That's awesome. Very cool.
I
want to
see Black Eyed Peas tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm security for Black Eyed Peas tonight.
Oh, that's sick. Are you security the entire like Music Fest and everything? What's been your favorite performance that you've seen thus far? Flash? Okay. What about Runner Up?
I'll say Joe Water Rundy.
Okay. Haven't heard of that one. Man, you really do meet cool people every day. I've been very fortunate for the past couple little travels and events that I've stepped out to. A lot of people have seen me kind of out just making my vlogs and everything, and they've been very receptive, very nice to me. So I appreciate you guys. If anybody's subscribed or if anybody's watching these, just know I really do appreciate connecting and meeting you guys.
Pretty much all of his artwork.
Oh, okay.
Like different celebrities and stuff. Like.
Whoa. Wow.
Macaulay Culkin.
Holy crap. These look pretty cool. Look at that. There's a cool Jim Carrey one there. This one kind of looks like Mac Miller. Might be Mac Miller in here. Very cool.
Yeah, me and my brother.
No way.
Yes, sir.
That's cool, man. Everything's hand-drawn or hand-painted. What's the method here?
Both, I guess.
Okay, gotcha.
If there's like a specific method, but we just do it, and if it's not good, we cover it up and do it again.
Okay. Sounds very foolproof. Got Swartz Brothers Art. I love that. Do you guys have a Instagram, a website and stuff like that, it looks like on here? Yeah,
gotta have it. Yeah.
Very cool, loving that. So how long does it usually take to like make one of these paintings and stuff? I'm assuming it varies. Yeah.
Oh, it does vary. That's the best answer,
right?
But I would say on average a day to a month.
Yeah, it's a very wide range.
Well, you know, it's like each one, like those butterflies I just did.
Okay.
So I did all those in one day.
Okay.
Yeah. And it was just like sitting there doing them.
Okay, gotcha.
When it's like bigger pieces, I like paint on it and cover up some. And
okay.
Change it.
What's the longest time that it's taken to build a piece?
The longest time would probably be a month, I'm going to say. Actually, here, this one right here, This one took a while.
Okay.
Just because I had to, like,
oh, whoa.
Going back and fixing stuff, you know what I mean?
That looks really good, though. Holy crap. Yeah, that looks very good.
Alice in Wonderland.
Yeah, I was literally just thinking that Alice in Wonderland kind of felt.
I would say, like, that's, like, a month. Not, like, every day working all day, but, right. Like, you know,
because you got to do other stuff.
Come back to, yeah. I got to eat. I got to go to the bathroom. I got to pay my bills. Got to
be a human.
Oh,
you know?
You're lazy.
Yeah, exactly. Got to do yard work sometimes.
Yeah, man. That's cool, though, man. Very cool.
And she was my girlfriend at the time, so I had to spend time with her also.
Yeah.
For God's sake.
Yeah.
No wonder she left you.
She's like, get out of here.
I'll hug her upside down.
She's yeah, no.
Man, those, seriously, though. Truly amazing work,
man.
Thank you, man. Very
I
good. Very cool. What was your name one more time for me, brother?
I'm John. John Swartz.
John Swartz. Okay, and then brother's name?
David Swartz.
David Swartz. Okay, cool. We got the card and we got the info. Appreciate you, man. Have a good fest.
Amen.
It is a little loud over here, but I'm sure you guys can hear me with my bold and booming Cam Brown Vlogs voice. We're going to get a little refill, our first refill with the Winky Blinky mug. See what we can find in the bourbon tent. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
What do we have over here for refill in the Winky Blinkies? What can we get in the mug?
We'll
get
together and I'll buy
the first. What you guys get?
I got bourbon and tons of water.
Bourbon and water, okay. John, what'd you get?
I got a Yingling.
Yingling flight?
I'm paying for them, though.
I will go. Let's try this, the Bullet Mule.
Alright, do you want a single?
What's a single meaning what? Like the 12 ounce versus 24?
Yeah, okay. Do you want the whole mug
filled? I'll do
that. Cool.
Just half?
Yeah, that's cool. Okay. The cocktails are being made. Our expert bartender is on the case. Look at that.
Her name's Robert.
Love that, love that. Oh, okay. Very nice. Yeah, man. Now do it with your eyes closed. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah.
Should we?
I kind of want to try.
All right. First try. Let's see what she's got.
Oh, I'm so nervous. Not this. Okay.
No, I'm doing it just so I remember.
Yeah, you
too.
Have a shot.
Ah, you were close. You were close, though. I'll edit it and make it go into the can for you. Drink refill is fresh. Very crisp. Y'all need to come out here and get one of these. It's a ginger mule. We are back down on this little bottom side street that I'm sure a lot of you recognize. Only difference is that yesterday was pouring. Today we are clear skies, clear-ish skies, I should say. But everyone knows that we're down on this side street. There's a bunch of other food tents, but really we're coming for one thing and one thing only.
Oh, shucks.
Oh.
Wait, let's get a selfie of Oh, Shucks behind us.
Yes, sir. That sounds right.
Dad, come here.
Cool.
If you know, you know.
OMG, baby.
That is
so that looks awesome, man. I don't know if you guys can see this, but holy crap. There we go. Got the All Sucks corn, baby.
Oh my God.
Taking that first bite. And how is it? John, what we got?
Ah, oh, shucks. That's good.
Nah. You guys saw this on day one, so my ear of corn is definitely halfway gone at this point. But I just want to give you guys kind of a close-up of this. Easily a staple of Musik Fest, I think. I feel like any Pennsylvania native or any avid Musik Fest goer will easily agree with me. This is like the mascot. There's something about it. Again, I don't know what it is. It's cheesy, it's savory, it is salty, it's buttery. It's just everything right. Headed into the infamous Hotel Bethlehem right now. Let's see if we can get lucky, see if they're serving any cocktails here. Thank you. Quality service as always with Mr. Blaylock. Subpar service with a wife, but that's okay.
Yeah, it's like a carrot. Do you see anything that has carrots?
I think I see my drink. Yeah.
We call
you guys the mules.
The mules. it's the mules.
Is it the browns? No, it's the mules. Okay, so prickly pear, Moravian, mule, and bourbon, yeah? Okay, cool. I'm gonna give you that.
This is your tip.
Okay.
And then charge it.
No problem. Thank you so much.
Thank you. This one to me is a very interesting little spicy pineapple mule. It's the first drink that I feel like has had two different flavors in one cocktail. So when you first sip it, it's got this really like delicious kind of like almost like vanilla tone coming in there. Sweet from the pineapple is definitely there. But again, it's like this vanilla kind of like strong flavor pushing through at the front. Then it literally pauses and then moves on to the next flavor, which is, it's so weird. I've taken like 3, 4, 5 sips of this pie. It literally pauses in the middle and moves on to the next flavor, which is like this really good dessert tasting almost caramel aftertaste with it. And of course you've got the flavors of the mule kind of complementing and mixing it as well. Again, very, very good. It's probably like my 10th time doing that to check, but yeah, it comes in two separate flavor palettes, but it's really good. Very impressive. I want everyone, if they can, to take a sip of mine. Mine has a very nice like dessert aftertone to it. Give it a sip.
Oh yeah, it's subtle.
Pa, you wanna give it a taste?
No!
No?
Okay.
But it's for the vlog.
If you insist.
Sorry, the pressure, it was the vlog.
It's for the vlog.
And then an interesting aftertone, right?
It reminds me of something, though, like an actual dessert.
It's like vanilla almost, right?
Yes. Vanilla, bourbon, maple, something.
They did a good job.
It's really good.
Drinks at Hotel Bethlehem were amazing. I'm going to come over here and see if my guys are still in here. I don't know if Mike's still in here or not. Yo, Mike, you back there? Hey, there he is. What's up, boss? I told you I was coming back, man.
How you doing?
Let me get some vegan tots, man.
You ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
I got them for you.
All right, man. Gotta come back. Gotta support my man Mike's business. I'm not lying. The tots were honestly one of my favorite items from Music Fest. I know I gave him a little shout out in the vlog earlier, but seriously, they do a great job. Mike's a great guy, and the food is really, really good. So, vegan loaded tots coming in hot, man. Hold on. I only got a couple hands, man. Hold on. There we go. Perfect. Do you mind if I put this up here on your little ledge so I can record myself?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right. Vegan loaded tots. So, Mike, what do we got here, man?
So, you got your tater tot base again.
Okay.
Then crumble impossible meat.
Okay.
Deep fried onion tanglers and a vegan mayo. All
right. Sounds good, man. That's a good one. All right, let's see what we got. That looks solid, man.
Yeah?
Yeah. That looks solid, bro.
Seriously. There we go. Keeping the vegans happy, you know?
The flavor, as I munch this down, savory, salty, but not too overbearing. You get that immediate taste of the Impossible Burger coming through. The veganaise is, of course, a good compliment. For me, the thing that's bringing it home that really like drives in that flavor and gives you a good solid taste in the entire dish is the onions. Everything else is satisfactory. Again, very good job, man. I appreciate it.
I'm glad.
Good stuff, bro.
No, I'm glad you're enjoying it.
Heck
glad
yeah, man.
I
wanna Heck
see
yeah.
The video. I'll leave this one of our student workers.
What's up, man? How you doing, bro?
I'm good. How are you?
What's your favorite tots, man?
Bacon
me crazy.
Bacon me crazy? Yeah.
Good stuff. Okay, what's the runner-up?
I think, as for me, as an international student, it's a good thing for having things like new things.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good stuff, bro.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
I'm an international student from Zambia.
Nice. Dude, we saw you guys running the Olympics not too early ago, man.
Yeah.
You guys did pretty good, man.
Yeah, thank you so much.
That's what's up, bro. Real nice to meet you. And so you told us you have a custom tot right now.
Yeah, I do a custom one.
What's the custom tots entail, bro?
So I do the bacon jam.
All right.
With bacon.
Right.
And I do the cheese sauce on it with
cheese sauce.
Sometimes, depending on how I feel, I put citrus aioli, but that's just depending on if I'm feeling.
So what do you call your creation, bro?
I don't even know what to call it. It's just good. I don't even know what to call it.
Damn. Yo, that looks so good, bro. Is there ranch on there too?
Blue cheese.
Blue cheese. Okay, yeah, do you have ranch?
We do not.
Damn,
we do not
okay.
have ranch. I do have blue cheese.
Damn, I might have to go.
But I don't
might,
have ranch.
I might have to give it a taste, man.
Thank
Mike,
you.
I need you to serve me up. Give me an Angry Buffalo.
You want right. an Angry Buffalo?
Yes, sir. You get the you last of our Music Fest money, all right?
You got it.
Mike, can I come see how you make it behind the hood?
As long as you put a hairnet on, I'm down.
I'm in.
Okay.
Good. Now, is there oh, here we go. I see.
Got that hair in there,
put
baby.
This in there. There we go.
We're good.
All right, let's do it.
Watch your step coming up.
Coming up. All right, here we go.
All right, so we start with our base of golden brown tater tots.
I love that. Looking good.
Yeah. Just gonna top that off with our Arizona hot sauce.
All right. Did I hear something sizzling back here?
Yeah, that's good. It dropped on the grill.
Okay. He did that on purpose. That was for effect.
Yeah. We open this up. Yeah, yeah. And we have the blue cheese.
All right, loving that. That looks good.
And then we go in with some jalapenos.
Yeah, quickly, quickly. That's looking good, man.
Then we grab our lid from up above.
Okay.
And we close it.
Making it travel friendly for me, right? Okay. And that right there is a full order. We love that.
Appreciate it. You have a good one.
Will do, man. But first,
thank you for coming by again. I appreciate you trying all of our tots.
We appreciate you guys, man. You guys are my favorite food truck.
Don't forget your hair.
Oh, no, I'm keeping it. That's a souvenir. That's a souvenir, man. You guys are around the area or enjoying Music Fest for the last couple days, please check out Hungry Hound Express again. They are quite literally my favorite food truck in the entire Music Fest experience. Let's try their Angry Buffalo Tots, see what we got. This is the Angry Buffalo Tots.
This is the Angry Buffalo Tots. We just got the vegan tots and the bacon meat crazy
get these guys
tots.
Off. Get a little of everything. All right, I'm going to get a jalapeno in there, a little blue cheese action. And a couple tots, of course. Ah, don't fall apart. There we go. That's looking good. 3, 2, 1. That's good. That's spicy. It's creamy a little bit. The jalapeno cuts through and gives it like a nice little, again, zing to it a little bit with the flavor. That's fire. And then, of course, the buffalo sauce on the tots. Yeah. Mike knows what he's doing, bro. So, hairnet and everything included, Angry Buffalo Tots were really good. If I'm being honest, though, I think I liked the Bacon Me Crazy Tots as first place and the Impossible as a very close second. Very, very close. Angry Buffalo was not bad in any stretch, but compared to the other two, I do have to put it as third place. Again, not bad, but third place. Those other two were just that good. Seriously, really good. All right, folks. And I think with that, we are bringing our Music Fest 2024 to an official close. I appreciate y'all for watching. I hope you enjoyed the vlogs as much as I did going around the festival and exploring everything that Music Fest had to offer for this year. As always, if you like what you're seeing, hit a notification bell, press that subscribe button, and support the channel how you will. And yeah, I appreciate y'all for watching, and I guess I'll catch you guys in the next adventure. Peace.
Hey,
get over here.
Oh. Or if you made your friend sit in the driver's seat, and then you controlled the car and you hit somebody, whose fault would it be?
Oh. Imagine it just floors it. Are we really doing this right now?
We're doing this right now. In the pouring rain.
Alright, a little bit. Ah! I'm melting! I'm melting! Okay.
Hello. Oh. That's the sugar free and that's the sugar free. So it's limited.
We are here. So I know that I said that this vlog ended maybe a couple minutes ago at Music Fest, but in reality it didn't really end. We decided to carry on the festivities a little bit past Music Fest, past sundown. We're out here getting some readers. I also have to show you guys one more special item that I mentioned a little bit earlier on the vlog, so let's see who's paying attention.
He's trying to not get one. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Oh no, here she goes.
Yeah, exactly. Puts it directly in front of the vlog camera.
Oh my god, it's pouring, you guys.
Oh no.
Come on, Stormtrooper.
Two. What? Oh no.
Never mind. That wasn't fun.
Oh, it's cold. It's cold. It's cold on my feet. We're literally in this tiny little area right here. Trying to stay dry. Well, how is it? Did you try it? You didn't try it? I see you chewing on something right now. Ah, okay.
I literally got one with my
classic.
Thank you. See ya.
Yeah.
So I got a small cookies and cream.
Right.
Gelati.
Mm-hmm.
With vanilla custard, rainbow sprinkle.
Okay.
And
babe.
I got my usual, although I want them to be different because they have a lot of custard. I couldn't think fast enough. So I got a small mango gelati, vanilla custard, rainbow sprinkle.
Oh, okay.
Oh, what'd you get, Papa?
Nothing! Some of you may have noticed earlier in the vlog, before all of the fun Music Fest festivities and such, we received a package courtesy of Pa coming out of CI. This and this are two one-of-a-kind instruments when it comes to the world of cigars. So let me introduce you real quick. We're gonna do a little bit of an unboxing here. This is the Herf Metal Ashtray and what I like to call the Herf Tesseract cigar lighter. And you'll see why in just a second. So, pull this guy out. Another nickname for this ashtray that I call it is the dog bowl. Because as you can see, look at that thing, dude. Holy crap. That's enormous. Huge, man. Huge. And it's got some heft to it, dude. That thing is, it's at least like 2 pounds, maybe 3. That's a solid piece of work there. But the real showstopper is right in here. Unassuming, quiet, and, you know, simple little white box, but inside is a matching piece. Now, on the outside, looks just like a regular box. Pretty cool. But we've got some hidden features built into this boy. So we'll start out right here on the front. 4 letters, 2 of them perform actions. The H is a full torch lighter, as you guys can see. The F is a small torch lighter. That is built in for touch-ups on your cigar. Whenever you're getting a cigar that's burning kind of crooked or wonky or whatever, you use the F and you can touch it up on the edge. Just do a light little edge up and make sure that your cigar is back in working order. Last but not least, we've got these two little buttons right here on the side, one of which is a hole punch for your cigar right there. So again, that punches right out the bottom of the box. Same thing on this other side, but just a different size. So whether you like a slightly bigger punch for your cigar or a slightly narrower punch for your cigar, you're covered either way. And of course, last function, but also one of the most important, I'll demonstrate to you right here with a demo cigar. This, in addition to all of its other features, serves as a proper cigar rest. For when you are just chilling, not puffing your cigar, it can just sit and have an actual place to be on its own. So, pretty cool.
Really, really cool. Thank you, Paul. And just like that, we are in business. So, once again, as always, if you guys have watched until this point, if you made it to the end of the vlog, I appreciate you guys for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this vlog as much as I enjoyed running around Musik Fest with my friends and family, and you know, bringing all these fun adventures and all that stuff to you guys via the channel and everything. So, I will send you off with a proper goodbye. And I guess until next time, I'll see you guys later.